Hello all, this is the third lecture of the lecture series on moving loads and influence lines. In this lecture we will be seeing the influence line and the responses when a train of concentrated loads are acting on the member. Also we will see the overhang beam case as well. This comes under module 4 of structural analysis 1 for S4 BTech civil engineering students. So what do you mean by train of concentrated loads? It is a series of wheel loads with specific magnitudes with specified distances of separation between them. For example, the vehicles with multiple axles access multiple concentrated loads. The distance between the wheels are specified and it is a constant, and those loads will be having some specific magnitudes. So let us consider a beam AB, and let us consider a train of loads P1 to P5. Acting at a distance from x1, x2 up to x4. So to locate the maximum bending moment, you need to follow a procedure. The maximum bending moment at a particular section in a simply supported beam under a train of concentrated load occurs when a particular load is located at the section, such that when this load crosses over the section, the average load on the segment to the left of the section minus the average load on the segment to the right of the section changes its sign. This is how you can locate the maximum bending moment condition. Okay, which load has to be placed on section C. So we'll be explaining this elaborately with the help of a problem. Then only you'll be able to understand what has been explained as how to locate the maximum bending moment. So consider a question. For the wheel loads shown, find the maximum value of bending moment at a section 18 meters from the left hand side when the load crosses the beam of 45 meter span. So the total span of the beam is 45 meters and the train is 18 meters, the section is at 18 meters from the left hand side of the support. So let us draw this table and let us see that where the maximum bending moment will occur. Okay. So let us consider first the load 12 kilonewton is crossing C. That is the situation that is shown. That is, to the right side of C is only 12 kilonewton, rest all the loads are to the left hand side of C. So average load on AC, the member on the section AC, what is the average load? 17 plus 15 plus 8 plus 5 divided by the total load. Total load is, divided by the total length. Length is 18, right? 5 plus 5 plus 4 plus 4, that is 18. So that is 2.5. Now average load on CB is how much? 18 is what? Length of AC. Okay, and the average load on CB is 12, the only that load, divided by the length of BC is 27. So you will get it as 0.44. What's the difference? 2.056. Now let us consider the second case. In the second case, the load 17 kilonewton is also crossing the section C. Now what's the average load on AC? 15 plus 8 plus 5 divided by the length of AC, which is 18. You will get it as 1.556. And average load on CB will be 12 plus 17 by 27, which is 1.07. So the difference is 0.482. Now let us consider the third case where the 15 kilonewton also crosses the member, section C. So 15 kilonewton load is crossing section C. The average load on section AC is 8 plus 5 by 18, which is 0.722. And on CB it is 1.63, and the value of difference is minus 0.98. So when the load 15 crosses, the value changes, right? So plus 0.482 changes to minus 0.908 when 15 kilonewton crosses the section C. Hence the section will be having maximum bending moment when the 15 kilonewton is placed on C. So now the 15 kilonewton is now placed on C. Okay. So the total AC was 18 meters. Now from 18 meters at the initial point of 5 kilonewton, it will be up to 5 kilonewton from A, the distance will be 8 meters. Similarly, up to 12 kilonewtons from B, the distance will be 17 meters. You just calculate. Okay. Now we let us draw the bending moment diagram. You know this is the influence line diagram for the bending moment at section C. So what is the center maximum? C into L minus C by L. What is that value? C is 18 meters, L is 45. So C 18 into 45 minus 18 by 2, you'll be getting it as 10.8. Similarly, you try to calculate the ordinates of the influence line diagram just below each load. Okay. Just immediately below each load. So now you will be getting the values as 4.8, 7.2, 8.4 and 6.8. So now what is bending moment? Maximum bending moment at C, it will be that load into corresponding ordinate. 5 into 4.8 plus 8 into 7.2 plus 15 into 10.8 plus 17 into 8.4 plus 12 into 6.8. And you will get that as 468 kilonewton meters. For the above problem, determine the absolute maximum bending moment. So it's a strain, same set that is given. So the absolute maximum bending moment under will occur under the heavier load falling close to the center of gravity of the load system. So where will you, how will you locate the center of gravity? Let us consider O as the origin. So 8 into 4 plus 15 into 10 plus 17 into 16 plus 12 into 20. That is the moment of each force about the point O divided by the total magnitude of the force. 5 plus 8 plus 15 plus 17 plus 12. So you'll get that as 12.18 meters. So that is the position. This is how you locate the centroid. Now how will you get the absolute maximum bending moment? It occurs under the heavier load falling close to the CG. Okay, so you see 15 and 17. CG is between 15 and 17. And 15 is at a distance of 2.18 and 17 is at a distance of around 4 meters, right? 15 around 2 meters and 17 around 4 meters. So absolute maximum bending moment will occur under 15 kilonewton. Okay. Now you cannot directly keep 15 kilonewton on top of section on top of the member. Now you have to locate where the train of loads has to be kept, right? So the position of 15 kilonewton should be such that the center of the 45 meter span. The beam is having a length of 45 meters, so center of 45 meters should be midway between the 15 kilonewton and the center of gravity of the load system. So what is it? 45 meter is the member, okay, and C is the midpoint, okay. So 15 kilonewton should be placed such that the center of gravity and 15 kilonewton, you see this distance is how much? 2.18, right? Between 15 kilonewton and the center of gravity, it is 2.18. So that distance should be bisecting C. Okay, so that is, this distance should be 2.18 by 2, which is 1.09 meters. So you have to locate it that way. Okay, so what is the peak maximum bending moment will be at a distance of 22.5 minus 1.09, which is at 21.41. So that will be your C. Okay. So we'll take it as instead, we'll not confuse it with C. That will be your X, where the maximum bending moment will occur. So that is given by X into L minus X by L, which you will get as X is 21.41 and L is 45. You'll get it as 11.2. Now you have got this altitude and you know this length as 21.41, so you can find out the other ordinates using similar triangles. So you'll get this as 6, this as 8.1, 8.4 and 6.5. Now how will you get the bending moment? Multiply with the corresponding loads. So 5 into 6 plus 8 into 8.1 plus 15 into 11.2 minus 17 into 8.4 plus 12 into 6.4. 5, you will be getting it as 483.6 kilonewton meters. Now let us consider the how to draw the influence line diagram for an overhanging beam. You don't have to worry, whatever we have done till now, it's just the extension of that. So this is what we have done for a beam, simply supported beam. This is how the reactions are going to be, right? And the shear force diagram and the bending moment diagram for a given section C. Now this is for any kind of loading, whether it be UDL or a concentrated load. Now let us consider the overhanging case. Okay, so at from A to the left is overhang of A, small a, and from the support B to the right an overhang of small b. So the reaction exactly, you see this is the same reaction from A to B, it is the same diagram, right? It is 1 meter at A and 0 at B, right? For the simply supported also it is 1 meter at A and 0 at B. Now what did you do? You extend that line, you extend that line and get the value, which will be 1 plus A by L here, and you extend this inclined line to this side also, so you will be getting this diagram. Okay, similarly for the reaction at B, what will be the case? The same reaction case, you extend it. The same case for shear force diagram also. Shear force also from A to B, it is the same figure. Okay, and from to the left of A and to the right of B, you are just extending that diagram. Similarly for the bending moment case also. So let us see one problem. A simply supported beam with overhang at its ends is loaded as shown. Using influence line, determine reactions at A and B, shear force and bending moment at a point 2 meter from the left support. Okay, so it's section C, which is at a distance of 2 meters from the left support. So how will you get the reaction at A? You know the influence line diagram for the reaction at A, right? So just draw that figure, and wherever you need that section, that values, you just put the values, right? So at the end it will be 1.2, where 20 kilonewton load is acting, it is 1.2, and where 50 kilonewton load is acting, it is 0.6, and where this 10 kilonewton load is acting at the ordinate at the left end, it will be 0.3. okay, similarly for the reaction at B, you just draw the influence line diagram for B and calculate the ordinates. And similarly for the shear force, C by L and 1 minus C by L, you already know. Similar to that, you're using the similar triangles, you find out the other two ordinates, and similarly for bending moment at C. So this is how we have calculated, right, the for the reaction. Now you have to get the reaction at A, right? How will you get the reaction? Reaction at A, VA will be equal to minus 20 into 1.2. Why minus 20 into 1.2? Because it is in the negative direction. Okay, so 20 kilonewton into the ordinate in corresponding to that is 1.2. similarly 50 kilonewton into 0.6, it is the ordinate at that point, and plus 10 kilonewton because it is to the upper side, so it is positive. Okay, you can see the shear force is to the, from the baseline it is to the upper side, so plus 10 into area of that triangular triangular portion, shaded portion, half into 1.5 into 0.3, so that is minus 51.75 kilonewton. Okay, so this is how the shear force diagram that we have taken, from the base when it is to the downward side, we'll take it as negative, and to the upward it will be positive. So just follow the sign convention. Now when you consider for the reaction at B, only the left portion is down from the datum, from the baseline, and the remaining, the triangular, big triangular portion is upward from the baseline. So how will you get the value of reaction at B? Minus 20 into 0.2, because that small triangular portion is to the downward, plus 50 into 0.4, plus 10 into half into base into, now in this case it is a trapezium, right? So half into base 1.5 into sum of the altitudes, 1 plus 1.3, so you'll get it as 33.25 kilonewtons. Now how about the shear force diagram? You, to get the shear force, you calculate the ordinates, and then shear forces, again when it is negative you put negative, right? So minus 20 into 0.2, now plus 50 into 0.4, that is the positive shear force at section C, then minus 50 into 0.6, which is the negative shear force at that section, plus 10 into half into base into altitude, 1.5 into 0.3, you will get it as minus 11.75 kilonewtons. Now to get the bending moment, you know this is the bending moment diagram for overhanging beam. Now what is the bending moment? Minus 20 into 0.6, plus 50 into 1.2, minus 10 into half into 1.5 into 0.6. You will get it as 43.5 kilonewton meters. So this is how you do it for an overhanging beam. So in this case, please note that you have calculated the bending moment shear force for a given set of loading acting at a given location. Okay, the load is not moving. The 20 kilonewton is acting at the center, 50 kilonewton at the center, and 10 kilonewton per meter in the overhang. This is the case. For that, we are doing all these things. All you have got to keep in mind is that the bending moment diagram, the shear force diagram for a given section, and the reactions at A and B is having a regular pattern for the influence line. The influence line diagram for these are a regular pattern, is having a regular pattern for any kind of loading. Just keep all those patterns in your mind and just calculate the ordinates and do the regular calculation, the simple calculations as we have done now, to get the total bending moment or shear force. That is all.